Hey, this is Dustin from Streamlabs. Today, I'm going to show you how to better engage with your audience by adding the Event List widget. If you want to give your viewers immediate and permanent acknowledgement on your channel for donating, subscribing, purchasing merch, or interacting with you in some other way, the Event List widget is a great way to do that. It is a feed that constantly updates with these various activities. For this tutorial, we'll be showing the changes as we make them, so you can easily see what each option does. Once you've saved, you can also see a preview by launching the widget URL here. We'll start with a default event list widget and modify it to our style. Let's try a couple of these out. And go with this one. And let's set the color to red. Here, you can choose what events you want to appear in your feed. You can toggle each one on and off. For many channels, you may get a lot of followers during each broadcast and only want to highlight donations and subscriptions. You can do that by removing follows from the list and so on. Here, you can set the minimum amount for a bit donation to show. You might want to show bits, but only if it's a significant amount, say over 100. Now bit donations, which are lower than 100, will not show on your event list. Max events is another important setting, which lets you show how long the list will be showing at a given time. The more you have showing, the longer the list will be, taking up real estate on your scene. So make sure you have room for as many as you want to show. 3 to 4 seems like a good amount. Background color is different from theme color. What this does is change the background on your preview, which you can check out for testing later. Text color, font, and font size are all pretty simple. You can change these as you like. This looks good. The next part is fun, playing with the animations. There's a ton of options to choose from for how you want your events to appear and disappear from the list. Check out the animation speed and fade time. The animation speed is slowed down the higher the number is. Fade time can be set above 0 if you ever want the event list to disappear. Otherwise, it'll take that many seconds for the entire event to go away from the list. Other options allow you to flip the way events are displayed. For example, you can flip Y to have the events come from the bottom up. Lastly, if you have some knowledge of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, or a designer friend who does, you can customize your event list even more by enabling custom code. Click Save, and your event list is set up. Now you'll have to make sure to include the widget in your scene. In Streamlabs OBS Editor, under Sources, go to the plus sign, Add Event List, and press Add Source. Name it what you'd like. Since you've created the event list already, that you'll be adding an existing source. You can right-click and go to Properties to play with a couple more settings, like Width. When you get it just how you want it to look, move it over to where you want on your scene. If you aren't using Streamlabs OBS, you can place the widget by pasting the URL from the top as a browser source. That's the last step, and you're all done. Next time, you can use a pre-made event list by navigating to the Themes tab and clicking on Widget Themes. Once there, you can select the box labeled Event List and select one of the styles. From there, you can select the specific Event List widget and instantly add it to your source list. Once added, you can resize it, place it where you want, and then you're ready to go live. Be sure to download Streamlabs OBS by visiting streamlabs.com and hop into our Discord server at discord.gg/stream for live community support. Check out the links in the description below.